After due date of filing of GSTR 1, you as a recipient of goods and services are required to file your GSTR 2 statement as the next step. This video will introduce you to the GSTR 2 dashboard and its various sections. Once the supplier taxpayer uploads invoice data in GSTR 1, the GST portal auto-populates the details in GSTR 2A and GSTR 2 of the respective recipients based on their GSTIN. GSTR 2A is a read-only summary of invoices, which is based on the data as received from the suppliers. The invoices saved as well as submitted by the suppliers will be visible in GSTR 2A and will be indicated by their status. GSTR 2 is also a copy of GSTR 2A, except that it allows the receiver to take actions on the submitted invoices, which includes accepting, modifying, adding, rejecting the invoice details uploaded by suppliers, or keeping the invoices pending for action, depending on various situations. The receiver taxpayers can view the invoice data in GSTR 2 almost real time upon upload, even before the due date of filing GSTR 1 by the supplier taxpayer. If a supplier has saved invoices but has not submitted GSTR 1 yet, the receiver can add those auto-populated saved invoices using the Add Missing Invoice Details option and file GSTR 2. Such actions can be taken only after the due date of filing of GSTR 1 by the concerned suppliers. Let's go ahead and explore the GSTR 2 dashboard. To begin, you need to first log in to the GST portal and navigate to the Returns dashboard. The steps to do this have been explained in another video, Navigating to Returns Dashboard. Please refer to this video if you need any help. Once you reach the File Returns page, select the financial year and return filing period, that is the month for which you wish to view or file the return. I will use September 2017 as the tax month for this example. Click Search to view the Returns Dashboard. To access your auto-populated GSTR 2 statement, identify the tile that says Invoice Supplies Received by Taxpayer GSTR 2 and click either its header block or the button Prepare Online. Also notice that the tile indicates a due date for filing GSTR 2. Taxpayers need to file GSTR 2 of a tax period from 11th to 15th of the succeeding month or as notified. For example, GSTR 2 for the month of February 2018 needs to be filed between 11th and 15th of March 2018. However, for the July 2017 month, extended timeline for filing GSTR 2 is between 11th to 31st of October 2017. For the purpose of demonstration, I will go ahead and click the Prepare Online button to view my GSTR 2 dashboard. The first block, GSTR 2, Invoice Supplies Received by the Taxpayer, displays some basic information about your GST registration profile, the filing period, and the status of filing, along with the filing due date. Also notice that there is a small refresh button on top right-hand corner, denoted by two circular arrows. This button processes any incremental information or data relating to invoices, credit notes, debit notes, etc. that you might have added in the respective tiles. Scroll down to the bottom of the page and click the Generate Summary button to ensure auto-populated invoice details are reflected in your GSTR 2. You can click this button at an interval of 10 minutes. Each time after adding details or taking any action on auto-populated details to update the respective tiles. The summary of details included in GSTR 2 after acceptance, modification, and addition of invoices gets reflected in the respective tiles. These are the values of total taxable value, total tax, and total ITC available. In the GSTR 2 invoice details block, the first tile 3.4a Invoice Supplies Received from Registered Person including Reverse Charge Supplies is a combination of Sections 3 and 4a. Under Section 3, you can view all the invoice data uploaded and filed by your counterparties, marking you as the receiver taxpayer for a given tax period. This section is exclusively for received B2B supplies, that is the supplies received from another registered person. When the tax and ITC details show up in this section, you can accept, reject, modify, or keep the invoices pending in accordance with your records. You are also required to declare your ITC eligibility and avail credit for invoices that are either accepted or modified by you. In case any of your supplier taxpayers have missed adding one or more invoices, you can even add them here and avail credit on those invoices for the current tax period. The receiver taxpayer must take actions on all the invoices that appear under this section. If any invoice is left with the status of no action taken while proceeding with submission, the GST portal will throw an error and you will not be able to submit GSTR 2. An invoice that was auto-populated cannot be added as missing invoice in GSTR 2. If the receiver tries to add an invoice number same as any other auto-populated invoice for the supplier in a financial period, an error indicating duplicate invoice and seeking action on auto-drafted invoice will be displayed. This style also covers Section 4A, which includes invoice details pertaining to purchase of goods and services received from a registered taxable person that are currently notified under reverse charge, such as legal services, GTA, etc. Inward supplies attracting reverse charge may simply be marked by checking the box "Supply attracts reverse charge" while adding the supply details in GSTR 2. When adding a missing invoice, remember to correctly select the eligibility for ITC as inputs, input services, or capital goods to claim input credit for eligible supplies. In case you are eligible only for partial ITC, indicate the reduced amount in the relevant field. The next style covers invoices that come under Section 5A and 5B of Notified Form GSTR 2. Section 5 includes the details of bills of entry, BOE, of imported inputs or capital goods received from outside of India or SEZ units. Please note that the port code is of 6 digits and the bill of entry number is of 7 digits. Combined together, they should add up to 13 digits. Supplies received from SEZ units require selecting the appropriate checkbox to indicate that. Please note that GSTIN of supplier is a mandatory field for supplies received from SEZ units. The next style covers Section 4C, which pertains to imports of services. As a receiver, you need to add the invoice details of all services here that you had imported during the given tax period. In the next style, 6C for debit and credit notes for supplies from registered person, you will be able to see all the credit and debit notes that were issued to you by the registered suppliers. You can accept, reject, modify, or mark these as pending once the supplier has filed their GSTR 1. In case any debit or credit note issued to you has not been uploaded by the supplier, you can add that yourself just like adding a missing invoice. However, remember that each debit or credit note can only be linked to a single unique invoice number. You can claim ITC for the debit notes that were accepted, modified, or added in your GSTR 2 statement. Section 4B captures invoice details of inward supplies in excess of the prescribed monetary limit per day received from all unregistered suppliers. Please note that since these supplies are from unregistered suppliers, you will need to pay GST on the same under the reverse charge mechanism. ITC, if available, can be claimed against such supplies. In case total purchases from unregistered suppliers exceed the prescribed monetary limit for any day, then the entire purchase for the affected day needs to be reported to a consolidated monthly invoice. The total tile for Section 6C captures the details of the debit and credit notes issued for unregistered suppliers. We should remember the rule that each debit or credit note uploaded can only be linked to a single unique invoice number. Next is the GSTR 2 Other Details block. In this block, the summary details for the tax period are to be reported. The first tile in this block includes summary of intra-state inward supplies from composition dealers and both Intrastate and interstate inward supplies of goods and services that are either exempt, NIL rated or non-GST. Exempt other than NIL rated non-GST goods or services are those which are currently exempt through notification. NIL rated means goods or services that are listed as taxable under the GST regime but assigned a NIL or zero rate of tax. This does not include zero rated supplies such as export or SEZ supplies as notified under the IGST law. Non-GST supplies are of goods and services that fall outside the jurisdiction of GST. Examples of such goods are petroleum and petroleum products, alcohol for human consumption, etc. The next style covers Section 10A, which relates to the advance amount paid against reverse charge supplies. Here, the receiver taxpayer needs to add the state-wise summary of tax liability, which is accrued from advances paid for inward supplies, subject to reverse charge. These will include advances paid to both registered and unregistered taxable persons. Similarly, in the next style of Section 10B, the state-wise summary of adjustment of advance amount paid on inward supplies has to be declared. It is for declaring adjustments of reverse charge tax paid in earlier tax period at the time of received of advance for which supplies are made in current tax period. The invoice of such supplies may be added in relevant sections in current tax period. Just to highlight here, these are the adjustment of advances that were declared in earlier tax period under Section 10A. In the next style of Section 13, you need to add the HSN-wise summary of all inward supplies. This should include details of the total quantity along with unique quantity code, UQC, total value of supplies, total taxable value of supplies and all the taxes, that is IGST, CGST, SGST and CESS, paid on the inward supply. Please make sure that the HSN-UQC combination is unique. Lastly, the time for Section 11, input tax credit reversal or reclaim, is for declaring the reversal or reclaim of ITC credit for that tax period. This reversal of ITC adds up to the total liability and also covers cases of reclaiming the ITC which was earlier reversed, thereby reducing the output tax liability. After entering all the details in the respective tiles, you can generate the GSTR2 summary by clicking this button here. This option will update the summary on the GSTR2 dashboard tiles and will allow the recipients to view the number of accepted and modified auto-drafted invoices, credit notes, debit notes, etc., as well as missing details that you must have added on the respective tiles. In other words, this option provides an opportunity to the taxpayers to reconcile the uploaded data with his accounting records and edit the entries if required before submitting GSTR2. The preview button creates a document of your GSTR2 which you can download and save on your computer for reference and verification purposes. Once done, the filing procedure first requires the taxpayer to select the acknowledgement checkbox and press the submit button. Please note that the submitting is not the same as filing. Submitting the form allows GST portal to make a quick validation check of all the entered details and highlight any errors that might need to be fixed. Once you submit the form, you cannot edit it, so be careful before you submit the form. Once the details get validated, just go ahead and accept the declaration that the form furnished is true and correct by checking this box here and file GSTR2 either by using DSC, EVC or eSign options. You can find detailed information about the steps of filing GSTR 1, 2 and generating GSTR 3 in other videos available under the help section of the GST portal. Thank you.